Rihanna have the best flow. Cardi B is the biggest female rapper. But Rhapsody is the most...
The singles video, that's Skywalk on your list.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah. And I found that was like one of the most slept on
songs
singles.
Of the year.
Yeah, for the year.
And videos. The real good tracks. 45 tracks with 40 bangers. If we're dealing...
culture.
I know this fucking man. The cover is fucking Migos.
It's out of pocket.
It's but something it's like, new though. It's like, it kind of housey.
Yeah, the
rap first hit play.
Say, yo. He's extra dramatic for this nigga real fucking. Yo. All you know, all you have to listen to Layla's wisdom.
Stop whatever you're doing.
Stop whatever you're doing and go and listen to it now.
So is your boy Gels.
Yo, run and well, end of year. You know, say so had a review. I make sure you know list up top 10 albums,
top 10 singles.
Yeah.
We've been inactive for a while. You know, we had a little technical difficulties, but the crew back together and we're trying to end the year right, give some for the Christmas, for the New Year, and then next year, big things coming. So, this is the top 10 albums and top 10 singles of 2017. We'll name this channel, we'll name this vlog later. Come with us for the journey.
She see money all around me. I look like I'm the man. Yeah, but I was counting out like last week.
Alright, so we back top 10 albums of 2017.
We did a mid-year top 10 list.
So go back, pause now, go back and watch that mid-year.
Yeah, so you can get an idea what changed.
The link would be somewhere on the screen. Your boy editing now, so shit official. You there? So you get kicked this one off. Was number 10?
Number 10, Chronology, Chronics.
Yeah, fuck, that's my number 10.
Yes, one of my favorite albums, I still listen to it all the time. He came to Trinidad just probably last month for a performance, I believe. You know, he was touring the Caribbean, and as a result of such, the media amped up, and all he could have heard on the radio
was
or anywhere else he went was Chronics. Number 9, I moved Flower Boy up. Flower Boy was my 10 the last time.
Mm-hmm.
I went back. I listened to it recently after the nomination, because the album got nominated for a Grammy. I was just like, yo.
Relative state.
Yeah.
My number 9 is Rhapsody, Layla's Wisdom. I said in the top 10 singles video that Rihanna have the best flow. Cardi B is the biggest female rapper. But Rhapsody is the most gifted, like in terms of ability to rap. No female rapper rapping like Rhapsody. Mm-hmm. And that album, it felt so well put together. It felt like a Kendrick album.
One Leisure, Miguel. Yeah.
The GOAT.
It just came out. I was actually driving up today, playing it with my homie. And I was just like, should I put this in the top 10? And he's like, dude, it's like, dog, you have to.
Yo.
I was like, weird, you know? Like,
my number 8 was Chris Brown, Heartbreak on a Full Moon. The real GOAT. 45 tracks with 40 bangers. If we're dealing with like ratio of songs and ability for them to be shit versus what you actually get, Chris Brown dropped the best album ever.
Feature good.
It's feature good. If that's how you say scale albums, like the longer you are, if you could keep me in tune.
Yeah, keep you in tune.
That's the best we've ever seen.
This might be a, I don't know, controversial. I put in culture.
You can't say culture. I know this fucking man. The cover is fucking Migos. Jesus Christ.
I was in culture, and if everybody who knows me knows I'm not particularly into this mumble rap shit, but
dog, I mean, Migos is legends though.
If I want to listen to some nigga shit, if I want to go and spend some money, play culture.
My number 7 was Miguel One Leisure. If you follow me on Twitter, even on Instagram, I was championing Miguel from the minute he dropped Skywalker. I was like, this album's gonna be amazing. If this album came out earlier in the year, it might have been higher. He's Miguel. Right. So One Leisure, I mean, 45 minutes, nice and concise. These songs are so potent, so good. He has a song on the album called Wolf. That shit just is like some Prince level music.
Yeah, that man is cool.
He's top five coolest people on the day.
Moving on to six.
Yeah.
I had Layla's Wisdom by Rhapsody. So Rhapsody, Layla's Wisdom, please listen to it. The samples clean. 9 to Wonder, big up 9 to Wonder. He actually retweeted and favorited and answered my tweet the other day.
Nine to Wonder. Okay, okay.
Doing the production on the album.
We out here. So. My number six album was Go Link at what cost? Go Link, super creative. You'll not be disappointed. He revived former legend, R&B legend Maya on a track on the album. It was amazing to hear her again. You know, with crew on your album, you're definitely going to be in some kind of top 10 list.
Moving on to number five, Control by SZA. The more I listen to it, the more I appreciate it. I love her voice. She has this kind of unique, it's not very nasal, but it's very,
it's kind of spacious.
Raspy kind of, you know.
It's ethereal.
Lawyer, man, lawyer. Lawyer. You know, because I personally, and I always say that I champion R&B. And, you know, SZA, along with Miguel and a lot of other artists, they're kind of rebuilding and revamping and bringing back that true essence of R&B now.
My number five was All American Badass, Joey Badass. I just really like that nigga though. He is one of the few younger rappers who never at any point in time bought into fitting into whatever the trend was.
He kind of dialed back on the boom bap. I mean, it's that boom bap elements in it.
He's trying to be a bigger artist now, so to be more appealing, he needs to find that balance, and he did it well.
Moving on for me, it's actually, we just spoke about the album, Joey Badass.
Oh, right, Joey.
All American Badass.
My four was Tyler, Flower Boy.
You push yours up.
It went up for me. I don't need to say anything more about the album. I said it's in the media review and he just touched on it again, so that was my number four.
And number three for me is Big Fish Theory, Vince Staples. My number two was 444, Jay-Z, and Kendrick. Damn, went up to that number one spot for me. In terms of
replay. No surprise there.
I mean, to me, in terms of replay value, and constantly go back and listen to it. Not that I don't listen to 444, but 444 is a moodier album. If you listen to it, you get into a mood. For the Kendrick album, I could bump it, still get the elements of moodiness, and still get the elements of ratchetness, if you want to see. You know, it's more well-rounded for me. So that's how you end up bumping up to the number ones. But don't forget Vince Staples, it still remain number three for me. And it's like, it's a genre, I don't know, it's out of pocket.
It's something it's like, you know, it's like, get my housey.
Yeah,
when I first hit play,
I was like,
I was confused on it. But some art, dude. You know what else really good about that? The way in which Vince finds his pockets.
Yeah.
With his voice. My top three, number three, was Vince Staples, Big Fish Theory. Number two was Kendrick Lamar, Damn.
So you're trusting.
And number one was Drake, More Life. Alright, that obviously was number one. That's number 1,000. But number one album was obviously Jay-Z 444, the most immaculate album to drop this year. Anybody who followed me on social media obviously know I went to Jay-Z's concert. I mean, apart from that though, I'll just briefly talk about the tour before I really get into the album. The tour was the best experience of my life. Side note, I met Dave Chappelle. He gave me a pound. We interacted. I learned to sit and things. He's a cool guy. Dog, Jay-Z is the best performer in rap. And not in terms of energy. We're talking about ability to command a crowd. Like, this man did his whole show alone. He had no guest features. He had no props, no dancers. Him on the stage alone. And he just delivering the music so clear, dog. No background vocals playing. It's just Hov, not out of breath. This nigga's 40. How he used the songs of the album, the sequence that he performed it in and the other hits he chucked in between them was it was amazing. And that album, it's so well put together. It's like perfectly wrapped. You couldn't take out a track or put in another one. It was perfect. The message, and I think the most important thing about the album, what I like it the most, is that album did something for hip-hop that no other album ever did. It made it possible for mature rappers to rap a mature content and still be relevant and
still resonate
with people. You understand? Like, that's the first time that ever happened. Mm. Jay-Z dropped that album and it sounded so good. The content was so different and mature, and it everybody checked for it.
Mm-hmm.
That is like unprecedented. I think that alone is the reason why that should be number one album. The album got nominated for Album of the Year in Grammys. Oh, yeah. I don't think he's gonna win. I think they're gonna give whack-ass Bruno Mars that album. Could actually win that one. Which is crazy. That was the top 10 albums of the year. Hope y'all enjoyed the video. We have some real amazing content coming for y'all during this carnival season. You're definitely gonna wanna subscribe and tune into the channel. You're gonna wanna follow me on Twitter, follow Darren on Twitter, follow me on Instagram, Darren on Instagram. I am at Gelsman. There's gonna be a link because, as I said before, your boy editor now. This shit is official. Like, this shit is at full volume. So at Gelsman.
At Darren Andrews and everything.
First name Gels, last name Man. That's my name. Yeah, so we're gonna be doing something real special for the carnival season, and we're gonna take this channel where it needs to be. You know, subscribe to the channel. I was Gels.
He's Ron.
We'll name this channel later.
Stay tuned and look out.
Oh,
yeah, that's it.